Hi there! This video will show you how to set up and edit your Instructor Profile widget in your D2L course pages. The widget will appear on the right-hand column of each D2L page. If you are a facilitator in a class, you will also have a widget in this position. On the left-hand side, you see the instructor view of the widget, and on the right-hand side, you see what the student would see if you do nothing at all. So on the left-hand side, you can see that your name and your email address are automatically populated on the widget. However, what's shown in the light blue box is that you would need to add this information if you would like it to appear in the widget. On the right-hand side, you'll notice that if you do not edit any of the information in that light blue box, then it doesn't appear at all for the student, so they won't know what's missing from the widget. The nice thing is that if you don't do anything with this widget, or if you don't get to it by the first day of class, it's still helpful for the student because they will see your name and your email address on the homepage of the course. On the left side of the screenshot, again, you see the default version of the widget before it is edited. On the right-hand side, you can see that the full widget has been edited to include all of the information possible. Now, you don't have to have all of the information in your widget that is shown here. I'm just showing you all the different things that could be on the widget. You can add a profile photo. You can add your position title. You can add the address of the campus. You can add your office number and your office phone number. You can also add a link to your Twitter account and your LinkedIn profile. Now, all of the information in the top half of the widget will be populated automatically into all of your courses once it is filled in. On the bottom half of the widget, you have additional course information, which is specific to each individual course. This could include the office hours and up to 2 hyperlinks that you would like students to be able to click into directly from the widget. In this example, there's a link to an appointment page and a Zoom link for office hours. So before I do a live demo, I'll just summarize that there are 3 main sections that you need to edit in this new widget. A profile image, which you can upload, and you may already have that uploaded. Contact information that you can type directly into the fields in the profile. And any additional information you need for each specific course. Number 1 and number 2 on this screenshot are going to be the same for every single class. You only need to enter the information once, and it will populate all of your courses. Number 3 can be customized for each separate course that you teach. So let's take a look at how you do this. So here I am in the default widget. It has already pulled in my name and my email address directly from the class list, but now I need to add some other things. So the first thing I'm going to add is my profile image, which you may already have, or you may want to bring in a new picture. Either way, we're going to click into the blue box into the Edit My Profile link. Now here you want to bring in a picture from somewhere on your computer. So you need to already have a JPEG or a PNG file that is a headshot or a casual image of you or some kind of icon or avatar image. So I'm going to click Change Picture and I'm going to pull it in from my computer. Click Upload. I've got a headshot from 2021. Click Open and Add. And there is my picture. Great. So now when I save and close, I'll show you what that looks like. So now my image has been uploaded and it will be there in all of my courses. The next thing I want to do is go into this blue box and decide which of these fields I actually want to use. These are the names of the fields that you'll see in the profile. The first one is position, the next one is office address. Obviously, fax numbers are not something we really have anymore, but you can put an office phone, etc. So I'm going to click the blue link that says Edit My Profile, and it takes you to that same exact place where we just were. And I'm going to look for those fields. Here I am in my user profile, and you can see that I've already started to fill out the fields. I filled out my Twitter handle. I filled out the LinkedIn field with my LinkedIn profile page. I put in my office phone number, my office room number, my office location, meaning the address of Normandale, and then I put in my position title. So now I'm going to hit save and close. And you can see that my entire widget is filled out with all of the contact information. Now remember, if you leave some of these fields blank, they just won't show up for the students at all. So now I want to fill out the last part of the widget, which is the course info. In order to do this, you want to click the blue link that says Edit Course Info. And here you might put something like your office hours. And then there are places for two separate hyperlinks. You see link name and link URL, and then link to name and link to URL. If you only want one link, for example, to a Zoom room, you would fill out the name, which would be what the students see to click on the link, and then you would fill out the URL web address. If you want a second link, you would do the same thing here. You would put the name of what you want the students to see that they would click on, and then the URL address. So for this example, I'm going to put a book an appointment link, and I'm going to grab the address for my bookings page. For link number two, I'm going to put my Zoom office hours link. You would paste in here the link to your Zoom meeting. And just so you know, if you'd rather that the students actually see the address of the URL rather than a different kind of name, you can just paste the Zoom link in there as well. I'll show you what that looks like. I'll go ahead and hit submit. And so now what it's done is it's divided that information into the course info, whatever I typed in the box there, and it's showing me two bullet points, one for the first URL that I used and one for the second. Notice for the first one, the link name was text that I actually typed in there. And then the second one, I actually pasted the URL address for both the link name and the link. You can decide how you want that to appear for students. It might be more clear if you keep it consistent. So in that case, I'm just going to change my link to name to Zoom Office Hours, and you will see that it looks a little bit more consistent in there. A book an appointment link and a Zoom Office Hours link. Now I'll show you what it looks like to a student. Now notice if I go up here and say View as Student, it's actually going to show me exactly the same thing. And that's not super helpful. I know that's a little confusing because we tend to think of View as Student as exactly what the student sees, but in this case, for this widget, that is not what you will see. So you just kind of have to trust that, or just watch what I do when I sign in as a student. Okay, so right now I am logged in with my fake student account, and you'll see that the blue box is gone, and I also don't see the blue button to edit the course info because obviously students can't do that either. So this is the nice clean version of what it looks like to a student. So I hope that helps. Reach out to the ITS Help Desk if you have any questions about using this widget, and watch our next video if you need to know what to do if you have more than one instructor or more than one leader in your course that needs a profile widget. Thanks for watching.